Well, that was lovely.
Yeah.
It was quite exciting.
It was. Quite noisy. Were you expecting something different?
Well, no, I'm glad, but you see, that's what I'm talking about. You see, that is exactly what I'm talking about. That's
what?
Amplified. That's electric sound. That's why it's good. That's why it gets you going. And now, what have we got now? A couple of acoustic.
Well, that shows the range, the talent.
Yeah. Well, let's hope so.
Indeed, yeah.
Tim and Charlotte from Ash are with us today. Is it just you guys left in Ash now, or do you still have a couple of other lesser talented members?
Yeah, well, I don't know. Maybe the most talented. Well, the drummer.
There's some lazier members.
Yeah.
Does a drummer count as a musician? I don't know if he's still a
drummer. No, that is debatable, yeah.
Because it's really more of a kind of craft, isn't it, really?
Yeah, it's a fine line.
But you've got a new album, congratulations on that. And are you playing this weekend?
Yeah, I'm playing Tuna Park today.
Today?
Yeah.
Wow. And hopefully the weather will stay good for you.
We hope so, yeah. We're in a tent, actually, so it's not too bad.
Well, that's okay.
Yeah.
What happens these days if there's rain outside? Is there a risk of electrocution of people on stage, or have they sort of dealt with that?
I think they've dealt with that now.
Because
late 60s.
Every time I see a gig, depending on who's playing, I'm either really worried or really hopeful when I see the clouds.
Yeah.
You know, but that used to happen, didn't it?
It did, I think.
Yeah, no. Yeah, if it's raining, they sort of come, you know, our roadies come out with bits of plastic and cover our sort of equipment. And
little bits of tape. Yeah, well, that's just to keep the equipment dry, probably, though.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah.
Do you have your outfits chosen for the performance today?
I have, actually, yeah. Allowed to take hand luggage with me, okay. So I had to pack everything very concisely.
And what are you wearing today?
I'm wearing a very spangly sequined gold top with jeans.
Sounds good.
Me too.
Do you have hats ready in case the heavens do up? Or are you in the tent? You don't have to worry.
Yeah.
That's all right, because otherwise...
No, my manager's brought as well, so...
I could see you all in sou'westers.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What the hell's
could
that?
Could be a new look.
Sou'wester, it's like a sailor's, a yachting thing with a... It's like
what's a hat that goes with it?
I don't know what it's called,
but it's
a good cap, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, yeah. The sou'wester hat.
It's the sort of thing the Beatles used to do. They would occasionally all go for one silly look.
Yeah.
You remember, like, the skiing look?
What about chefs? Yeah. That's chef suits.
You see, I think maybe Ash want to do a little bit more of that.
Yeah, definitely.
A bit more coordination. You know, never mind the spangly tops, that's okay.
Yeah.
You know, but let's get a uniform going on.
I'll take that on board.
Yeah.
Wellies and sou'westers.
They're doing well. They wear they're just like German ticket collectors or something.
Yeah, that's true indeed.
Don't let them steal the march on you. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
But it's all going well for you guys, isn't it? I mean,
great.
Been playing all over, haven't you?
Yeah, we've just been doing some festivals in Europe, and we did a big UK tour, and we're off to Australia next week and Japan, and yeah, so it's all go.
And do you get a chance to settle down at home much? I mean, do you actually have homes?
We have homes, yeah, but I was there one day or something, yeah, last week.
That seems strange. What happens to your house when you're away then? Who looks after for you?
Oh, I've got a lovely girlfriend looking after her. With a cat.
And who looks after her while you're away?
Her brother lives upstairs.
And who's looking after him?
Our manager lives with him.
See, what we've stumbled on here is a knock-on effect.
Very incestuous. Yeah, yeah.
It's not unlike the old lady who swallowed the fly. And then more and more things have to get added to it. Next thing you know, you've got a house living in your flat. And do you have a place, Charlotte?
Yeah, I share a place with a very hairy man.
Oh, you
know quite well.
A little tiny fella called Edgar.
Yes.
Who's part human.
Part wolf.
Part vole, I think. I'm
teen
not quite
wolf.
Sure. He is teen wolf. He is. Is he hairy all over?
No, he's got very sparse chest hair.
Oh, my goodness. So that must be quite something. Because he's got a very hairy face, hasn't he?
It's deceptive.
What about the back?
No.
Legs?
A little bit.
Feet?
A smattering of hair on the feet.
I have
hands. That's a test.
I've got quite hairy toes.
Nice.
So have I.
Mainly the big toe. Have you really?
Yeah.
Good look. Well, that's something to reveal. Do you wax it or do you just let it hang?
I just let it hang.
Wow, that's quite something. That's really quite a bold admission to make. Mm. Tim, I feel you're not really sharing here as much as you might.
Oh, yeah. I've got a hairy tattoo.
Look at that tattoo. Look at that tattoo. Now, you see, that was a mistake, I'll be honest with you.
Oh, it's close.
When you did it a few years ago, I'm sure it was considered quite rebellious. But now, look, you know, you've got grannies walking around with that sort of stuff on them.
Yeah, that's true, yeah.
What are you doing? And it's, oh, I've seen that. Hold on, look at that.
Yeah, it all ties in, doesn't it?
Wow, but you had that years ago.
No, I got this about 8 months ago.
Oh, so you had that for the album?
Yeah.
You're going to run out of space soon, aren't you?
I know, yeah.
have you done that for every album cover?
Yeah, I know. I've only started now. So.
There was a really funny thing I saw years ago in an American newspaper about it. Showed people, it was one of those rock magazines, and it showed people who'd had inappropriate tattoos done based on bands they liked once but didn't really like anymore. And there were like little kind of like silly cartoon characters that had been on obscure albums that people had loved when they were students, and now they were stuck with it on their inner thigh. So it can be a mistake. But that is quite a nice kind of tribal-looking design. So.
Yeah, I've got a Dave Grohl's tattoo. tattoo. So
all right.
Quite nice, yeah.
And did you have the album designed based on the tattoo, or did it happen vice versa?
Yeah, we based it on the tattoo.
Okay, well, that's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Now, you're gonna sound check now for us, and what track are you going to play?
We're going to do Starcrossed.
Okay, and that's the new single as well, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
All right, okay, well, we'll put the record on, give you a chance to warm yourself up.
And then we'll be performing after news, because we're going up to news after this.
Yeah. Oh, anticipation.
Just to let you know.
Why am I the rock and roll, eh?
I know, yeah.
What, we just forget the news?
Well, come on, the spirit of
noise. Where's the spontaneity?
Exactly. All right, go on then.
Well,
he's the man, you see.
Yeah, he's in charge.
He represents the man. Barry White. Oh, come on, Barry White. No longer with us, sadly.
I know. Can't go that low.
Now, one of the things I've always liked about Ash is the fact that you clearly like all the right things. You like comic books.
Yeah.
You like science fiction films.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You like horror.
Yeah.
You like trash culture generally.
Indeed.
Yes. You have impeccable credentials, Charlotte's mother having been impregnated in Carry On Camping.
Hey!
Which doesn't is get much better than that.
We can't not talk about every time you come on because it's just the most fabulous thing.
It's good. I got, Edgar got me the Carry On DVD box set for my birthday the other day. It's just so good.
Was it Mr. Fiddler or Mr. Ripper? I can't remember.
Mr. Fiddler.
Yeah.
Mr. Ripper would have been a different one than that. They never did Carry On Ripping, did they?
No.
Mr. Fiddler. And Charlotte has a solo project out coming later in the year.
Yeah.
We should spend a second talking about that.
Yeah. Well, it's an album I made in LA just before we made Meltdown, and it's coming out in August.
I heard a track. I went online and listened to a track, which was good. Very, very good indeed. I liked it a lot. And is that the single that you've got on
your... It was a download single, and then it's kind of free, available on the website. And then I got another single coming out in about 4 weeks.
Okay. How do you square that with the rest of the band? Do you go away and do it secretly and then say, and hope they don't know? Or do you run it past them first?
I ran it past them, and they said it was okay.
We were cool.
Well, that's good.
Yeah,
I had written consent.
You'd be bad
actually,
people.
Used some of his B-sides as well before.
Yeah, well, one of the songs was like a B-side and old
You see what he did there? He's trying to dismiss our solo project as B-sides. He's subtly trying to undermine it. Yeah, we got a few. Yeah, it's not bad stuff. It's B-sides, really. You know, stuff we rejected on her solo. Nice, Tim. Thanks. That's nice. We've got to get the news. When we come back, Ash will be playing live. 88 to 91 FM. This is Radio 2 from the BBC. XTC, what a great band. And that was from, is that Wasp Star?
Wasp Star, we agreed.
It's a great album. Get yourself a copy of that if you haven't got it already. We have with us Ash. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got Tim and Charlotte from Ash. Their new album is called Meltdown. It's out now. It is, of course, excellent. How many albums have you had out now?
Five or four and a half.
Four and a half. Wow,
yeah. You've had a mini album.
How many years has that been now?
10 years, 94.
I can't believe you've been going for 10 years.
Yeah. I've been going 12 years, actually.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. That's too scary. Yeah, but you started at school, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, school assemblies don't count, it.
Okay, all right.
And really, you weren't a proper band until Charlotte joined you.
That's true. Well, that's 7 years ago. That's
well, there you go.
Long,
well, then,
long innings.
Stop just throwing random numbers at us, will you?
Yeah. Five.
You'd be useless in, like, a police cell, wouldn't you? How many years you've been together? 12, 7, 9, 10? You've got to get all your stories straight. So you have to agree. Ash are performing live at Tea in the Park up in somewhere in Scotland today.
Glasgow.
In Glasgow.
Yes.
Okay, and so you're flying straight off after the show to get up there?
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
The rest of the band up there already?
Yeah, they went in the bus.
So did you fly down this morning, or were you here already?
We flew back from Belfast last night.
Wow, you're busy, aren't you?
Just to get here.
But is it fun doing all this whizzing around, or is it a bit much sometimes?
Yeah, it was good. It was good being home, actually. Saw the folks and all, and then it's good getting back for a night at home as well.
And you don't drink anymore, do you? Do you drink?
Yeah, I partake of...
So how do you must be, if you get knocking back in the evening...
Yeah.
It must be very tricky to get up and catch the plane on time.
That's why we employ a big, burly tour manager to wake us up in the morning, drag us out of bed.
Wouldn't it be great? Wouldn't you need just someone...
Your own tour manager?
Yeah, but like someone who could carry you in a bag.
Yeah.
That would be great, isn't it? Yeah. If you had sleeping bags, the new Harry Potter ones are good, I recommend them.
All right.
If you had like sleeping bags, they could just, with a little handle attached...
A body bag.
Just keep sleeping,
Yeah, and you could wake up when you're on the plane. Wouldn't that be great?
That would be good.
Yeah, let's put that on your list. Okay, Ash are going to play... not Ash, Tim and Charlotte. Sort of Ash.
Half of Ash.
Half of Ash. They're going to play the new single, Starcrossed, from the album Meltdown. Starcrossed is out right now, is it?
I think it's the 19th.
No, people come on, they're never out yet.
I know, we're off to Australia next week.
We get singles months in advance. It's really weird these days, isn't it? what do you mean off to Australia? So what did that? That was random, just starting the conversation.
Can't come in.
Yeah, now he's just showing off. Find a way, we know you travel the world. Don't rub it in.
Yeah.
People at home listening have never been out of the country. All right, well, on the eve of him travelling for Australia, Tim and Charlotte are now going to do Starcrossed. Do you need any help from us at all here?
Just count us in.
Okay. And one. and two.
They're faster.
Do you have to do it faster?
Oh, no. Whatever.
When I've counted people in before,
one, two,
I've counted in
one, two, three, four.
That's well, you make it sound so... Oh, well, that's it, is it?
Night still and clear, you look here just like an angel sleeping. I wish I could ease your fears, I would catch diamond tears you're weeping. In your eyes I would hide, by your side I could defy forces tearing us apart. But reality, as it seems, looking back, is that our dream was faded from the start. Girl, we're star-crossed and can't escape. We're condemned and can only wait. Time now, it's far too late to save us from our fate. I'll remain in your hold, body, mind, heart and soul, as long as I breathe. Consequence takes its toll, all is out of our control, it's how it will be. So close your eyes, my young bride, listen to me one last time, for something I have to say. When your faith turns to despair, always when will love be there and never.
Professionals.
Mm.
Professional. It sounded fantastic.
Hey.
Nice guitar sounds as well.
Uh-huh.
Really good. Well done. Congratulations to both of you.
Cheers.
Great backing vocals, everything going on there.
Full package.
See, that's what Ash do well. They got the, they got the rock power, yeah, and they got the sweet melodies.
Yeah.
You see, they got the both things. Mm. Some people can only do the rock power.
Yeah.
Some people only do sweetness.
Mm.
Ash, put them both together.
The rock and the roll.
That's what you get when you get Ash. Go and see Ash if you get the chance. I don't know if it's sold out, but if you are up near... Kinross, I believe it is.
Kinross, yeah.
Yeah, for Tea in the Pot, because also playing, what a great bill. You got Ash.
That's amazing.
You got The Darkness.
Yeah, I can't wait to see what the stadium ridiculousness they pull out.
Novelty band. No, they are, aren't they?
Filling in Bowie's shoes.
No, they're not. Don't you dare.
Well.
You'll be...
Hey.
The Charlatans.
Don't tell me.
Star Sailor, come on. Pink, she'll be good, I would have thought. Black Eyed Peas, the Black Eyed Peas are great. And Ocean Colour Scene.
Mm.
What a great lineup.
Yeah.
Well, you better get up there.
I know, yeah, better get going.
Hey, thanks so much for coming in.
Cheers,
great, thanks a lot.
And when your solo thing's out, Charlotte, if you want to come back on, you'd be very welcome. We'd love to have you back here.
Great.
So if the band let you to come out to do some of your B-sides, then, yeah, then, then you know, go, yeah, come on out. Okay, no, but it'd be lovely to see you back
here. Yeah, great.
Okay, have a great gig today. I hope it goes really
cheers,
well.
Thanks.
Nice to see you again.